These are the new voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before. Stardate 95.9066. All seems well with the universe. The Romulans, that warmongering race that lives just outside the known galaxy, and the Klingons, the sworn enemies of the Federation, have not shown their evil faces or tried to attack any civilized outpost for weeks. The Enterprise basks in the unusual peace. But in its place, the crew finds other things to occupy themselves with.
Captain Kirk! Ah, Captain!
Yes, Mr. Scott, what's the emergency? By the tone of your voice, I say it was an intergalactic calamity, at least.
Worse than that, Captain. It's my robots.
Your robots? What robots?
But that's just the point, Captain. They're not here. They haven't arrived. Ah, and I ordered the little buggers over 2 months ago.
Now, there, Engineer. There is no need to froth at the mouth. I'm sure they will turn up soon.
Froth at the mouth, Captain? It isn't just that they have not arrived, but shipments of robots have been disappearing all over this system for almost a year. And now it seems my little friends have joined their lost brothers.
Why, Scotty, you talk about the metal men as if they were human.
Captain Kirk, please report to the bridge. Priority one call coming in from Starbase 10. Captain Kirk, please report.
I'll be right there, Lieutenant Uhura. Thank you. Well, there you go, Scotty. One emergency on top of the other. I hope your robots arrive presently. And Scotty.
Yes, Captain.
Don't worry. Now, what's going on here? Any more missing robots?
Captain, how did you know?
What?
Captain, Commodore Decker calling from Starbase 10 on the 212 frequency.
Put him through, Lieutenant.
Captain Kirk.
Here, Steve.
Jim, good to hear your voice again. Welcome to the Vega system.
Thank you, Steve. What seems to be the problem?
Robots, Jim.
Not again.
You may be aware that entire fleets of robots have been hijacked in the system for quite some time. The Federation has just learned that these robberies have a far more insidious purpose than simple profit. These crooks are not selling the robots. They're training them.
Training?
Training? What do you mean by that, Steve?
It's even more serious than you can imagine, Jim. These villains are training the robots to be soldiers for the Romulans.
Training? Well, that is barbaric. It's vicious. Why, it's inhuman.
Easy there, Engineer. I totally agree with you, but the question is, what can we do about it? That's why I've called this meeting. First Officer Spark, please report your progress.
Captain, I have taken the liberty to arrange a decoy ship filled with robots moving on an exact course at the very edge of the Vega system. It is a primary attraction for the cybernetic criminals.
What I think he's trying to say, Captain, is that the decoy ship will certainly make a juicy target for those warmongering bunch of Romulan savages.
Heartily put, Ensign Jack. Allow Mr. Spark to continue.
I'm sorry, Captain.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Tanka and Lieutenant Uhura are carefully monitoring the decoy's flight. Given that each of the robot fleets thus far missing disappeared from that sector, I would calculate that we should hear something any moment.
Any moment, Mr. Spark? Isn't that guess rather optimistic?
Captain Kirk, please report to security. The decoy ship has been attacked. Captain Kirk, report to security immediately.
As I was saying, any moment, Captain.
Mr. Spock, your Vulcan logic never fails to amaze me. Battle stations, everyone. Mr. Chekhov, let's see if we can't put your energy to good use. We have a pirate ship to capture.
The mighty Starship Enterprise made quick work of the battle. No sooner had the Romulan pirate ship swooped in to attack the decoy robot traitor than did the Federation ship speed into nearby space at nearly warp factor 9. The villains never knew what hit them. Against the Enterprise's vast array of powerful weapons, the pirates might as well have been using water pistols. Officer Tanka rounded up the 5 Romulan crew members and hustled them down to the brig.
I got all of them, Captain. There were no escapes. There never are when Frank Tanka leads a raid.
Well done, Mr. Tanka. My congratulations. Mr. Scott, how is the interrogation coming?
Ah, Captain, those 5 are quieter than a child in a closed playground. I kind of got a word out of them.
Then we're back where we started.
Not quite, Captain. I took the liberty of examining the Romulan ship's computer. Wouldn't those tight-lipped bios be surprised if they knew their own machine betrayed them?
What is it, Scotty? What did you find?
Well, sir, nothing less than their destination. It was programmed into the navigational computer plain as day. These villains were taking these poor robots to a secret stronghold just outside the known galaxy.
A Romulan stronghold, eh? Mr. Tanka, please collect the energetic Mr. Chekhov and meet Mr. Scott, Mr. Spock, and myself at the Romulan pirate ship. Mr. Scott, why don't you relieve those pirates of their clothes? I think at least one of their outfits should fit each of us.
Now, just what is it you have in mind, Captain?
Scotty, our assignment is to break up this dirty ring of robot nappers. The only way we can is to capture the ringleader. And right now, the only way to do that is to disguise ourselves as the pirates and deliver those stolen robots to their destination.
Donning the evil robber's clothes, Captain Kirk becomes the leader of a band of robbing intergalactic cutthroats. Helping him fool the leader of the robot nappers are Scotty, Chekov, and Tanka, all disguised as pirates. Finding the pirate ship on automatic pilot, the four take off for unknown space.
Would you look at it, Captain? Hundreds of poor turned-off robots just clinking and clanking against each other. You would think those miserable space pirates would at least secure them.
They just have no respect for other people's property, Scotty. But we don't have time to protect every single one. What I want you to do, Engineer, is find the leader of these robots.
The leader, Captain? Why, it must be that big robot over there, the one with the almost human arms, legs, and head.
Good work, Scotty. Bring it over here, will you?
There we are, Captain.
Now, Scotty, Commodore Decker said these robots were being trained as war machines. Do you think you can train them to be peace machines?
Why, Captain, sure. A robot is just a machine a man can program to do a job automatically. If you can make them fight, you can certainly make them stop. Then they will not fight automatically.
All right, Scotty, you have your work cut out for you. Make sure these robots will not fight.
With pleasure, Captain.
Captain, we have just entered unknown, unexplored regions outside the galaxy.
Don't worry, Ensign. The ship will bring us to our destination safely.
But what happens when we get there, Jim? I bet the place will be crawling with Romulans.
Crawling? With those bloodthirsty beasts? By the stars, Captain, will we ever get out alive?
If my plan works, Mr. Chekov, we will. I only hope Mr. Scott is a fast worker.
Good in the galaxy. We're there already. Jim, Super Secret Robot Outpost is a small moon on the edge of the Federation galaxy.
Only the Klingons would have the goal to make a robot attack army right under our very noses.
Yes, Mr. Chekov. Curse those Romulans. Scotty, have you finished yet?
Not yet, Captain, but I'm going as fast as I can. I only have 2 hands.
Hurry, Engineer. Our lives depend on you.
Pirate ship Romulus 2, come in. Do you read me, Romulus 2? The all-powerful, almighty Romulan Empire demands your reply.
Captain Kirk, your orders?
Answer them, Mr. Tanker.
Romulus 2 reporting, all-powerful Romulan Empire. We are coming in for a landing.
Excellent. With your shipment of robots, we have enough metal warriors to attack Star Base 10 and destroy it utterly. Hurry, Romulus 2, so we can begin our complete annihilation of the Federation of Planets.
Welcome to the Romulus moon base, my dear pirates. I am Pragmar, the leader of the Romulan robot army. Please, show me my new metal fighters.
Thank you, oh great Pragmar. I am Jim Kirk, leader of these pirates. My first mate, Scotty, will show you the new robot leader.
Here he is, oh great Pragmar. This robot is specially programmed to lead the rest of the robots on a horrible killing attack.
Why, it is magnificent. So big, so lifelike. It will make a perfect metal commander to control the other robots. What do you call it?
Mastero. Yes, that's it, Mastero.
Superb! Mastero, as the leader of the Romulan robot army, I command you, make your warriors ready for immediate attack.
Yes, my mighty leader.
You mean you're going to attack now without planning?
We have already planned. The plan is programmed into every one of my 1,000 robots. We will not hesitate. We will destroy the Federation now. Please stay where you are, Jim Kirk. I will prepare my fellow Romulans.
Scotty, did you finish your work in time?
I don't know, Captain. I tried like the Dickens, but I can't be sure. There was so much to do.
I only hope for our sakes and the sake of the Federation we succeeded.
Captain, Pragmar is coming back, and he's bringing a whole bunch of Romulans and robots with him. And they're all carrying laser rifles.
Jim Kirk, you and your men must stay and witness our final triumph. All of you pirates, come with me now as I speak to my mighty army. My fellow Romulans, I am your leader, Pragmar. Too long have we suffered under the success of the Federation of Planets. Too long have we tried to extend our glorious empire out to the stars, only to be driven back by the starships of the Federation. Too long has the Federation defeated us. Today, we will be the victors! Today, my fellow Romulans, we will totally destroy Federation Starbase 10. We will destroy it with the help of our fellow warriors, the Romulan Robot Army, and its mighty leader, Master.
Scotty, I sure hope you had enough time.
So do I, Captain, so do I.
We'll soon find out, Captain. Look.
Suddenly, from all directions, came row upon row of shiny marching metal men. The robots each held a long, nasty-looking laser rifle in one of their metal claws. And leading them all was the huge, gleaming figure of Mastero, its big steel head looking the most evil and dangerous of all.
They're lining up, Captain. They're lining up, just like human soldiers.
Hush, come on. Pregnant right here. Quiet, both of you. Mastero's about to speak.
My robot friends, we are on a mission of destruction. We must totally demolish Federation Starbase 10. But we cannot stop there. Our programming states that we must go on. We must destroy the entire Federation. We must.
Scotty, it didn't work. Mastero is as deadly as any of them.
Captain, I don't believe it. I can't believe it. I thought for sure I had reprogrammed him. I knew I didn't have time to completely change him, but I felt sure I had programmed him not to allow any danger to threaten the Federation.
You mean nothing can stop the Romulans and the robots from destroying Starbase 10?
Nothing, my foolish Federation friends. Seize the spies, my fellow Romulans.
What? You knew?
Of course, Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Every Romulan warrior knows your face. The face of a man who has constantly defeated even the finest Romulan fighter. But today, it will be you who is defeated. And by the very robots you delivered into our hands.
No, no!
Yes, my fearful Ensign Chekhov. You shall all be killed by Mastero and his robots. Romulans, line up the Enterprise crew. Mastero!
Yes, my Romulan leader.
We have some Federation spies here from the Starship Enterprise. Do you see them?
Federation. I see them. Federation men.
Good. You know, Mastero, that the punishment for spying is death. Kill them, Mastero.
Kill Federation men?
Yes, Mastero, yes! Kill them, now!
I'm sorry, Captain.
It's all right, Scotty. If you couldn't do the job, then the job must have been impossible. I'm the one who should apologize for getting all of you into this mess.
I just don't understand it. I was so sure I had programmed him right.
My robot friends, we have a job to do. Follow me and attack.
Goodbye, Captain James Kirk.
And attack the Romulans.
I knew it. I knew I got it right. Go get the Master Roll.
What? This is impossible. No! You can't do this! Keep away from me, Mastero! I command you! I demand you keep away! Keep away! No!
Easy there, Mastero! Easy! Don't hurt him! Just capture them! Capture all the Romulans!
Capture the Romulans! It will be done, friend Scotty.
So, it seems as if Scotty's work was not incorrect after all.
No, Mr. Spock. He had done just what he thought he had. Although he had not been able to get rid of the war program completely, he made sure that the robots would not attack any member of the Federation.
Wonderful, noble machines, those robots. So logical. So unemotional.
I thought you would feel that way, Mr. Spock. So I had Scotty bring a friend along to meet you.
A friend?
And sure, Mr. Spock. Here he is now. Say hello to our Vulcan First Officer, Mastero.
Hello, Mr. Spock. I have heard so much about you.